Few weeks earlier, I released a video where you had to press a button so you can issue a voice command.
Turn on kitchen lights.
Turned on light.
Today, the things are changed for good. And they're actually much better, because now it is possible to use a waking word to do the same.
Okay, Nabu. Turn on kitchen lights.
Yes, it is working. It is just like a commercial smart speaker, isn't it? Stay with me and you see how I set my M5 Atom Echo for voice controlling my home assistant using wake words. Everything will be in an organized way with no confusing words, just clear instruction to set up my own smart speaker and get it working. Of course, you can do one or more for yourself. So, let's dive in. The needed things for voice controlling home assistant with a waking word are not much different than before. An ESP32 device with built-in mic, this could be the Tiny Titan M5 Atom Echo or Muse Lux or something similar. The latest home assistant is also needed, and if you don't have it yet, don't worry, check my webinar and see what are the best options for you. The webinar is all free. And the final requirement is the Open Wake Word add-on, available as one-click install in Home Assistant add-on store. This is the new stuff that allows magic to happen. All my respect goes to the Home Assistant guys contributing for this to become a reality. Hats off, fellas. I really believe this is a big step to a brighter Home Assistant and smart home future. Now, let's install that Open Wake Word add-on.
I'll open my Home Assistant and I'll press the C button to invoke this command search bar, and I'll type add-on, and I'll select add-on store. Here in the search bar, I'll type wake or open wake word, and I'll click on the selected result. This is the new add-on, and I'll just click on install button. Then I'll wait for the installation to finish. Okay, the open wake word is now installed. I can enable watchdog and auto update options, and then I'll click on start button. No configuration is needed at the moment. I can see the log file. Okay, I have the open wake word installed. So I can go to the next step. I press the C button again to invoke the command bar, and I'll type integrations, and I'll search for this auto-detected open wake word Wyoming protocol, and I'll click on configure, submit, and I'm ready with that part.
When we have open wake word in place, we need to quickly reconfigure or to create a new voice assistant pipeline. Let me explain. Next step is to edit my voice assist pipeline, and here I have two options: to use the cloud, but this requires Home Assistant Cloud or Nabucasa subscription, which have monthly fee, or I can choose to stay entirely local, and speech to text and text to speech processing will be done on my machine where the Home Assistant is running. And depending of the speed of this machine, this could be fast or slower. For this demo, I'll stay local only. So apart from the open wake word add-on that is needed, I need two more add-ons. I'll go to the add-on store again here, and I'll install Piper. I already installed it, and Whisper. These are speech to text and text to speech add-ons that I need to stay local only. I already installed that. And after that, I'll go to my overview section. I'll click on this assist button. I'll click on this down arrow, and I'll select Manage Assistants. From here, I can add a new assist pipeline, or I can edit the existing ones. I'll add a new one. I'll name it Wake Word. I can select different language here, but I'll stay with English. For speech to text, I'll select Faster Whisper. This is because I installed the Whisper add-on, as I showed you earlier. For text to speech, I'll select Piper. This is the other add-on that I installed. I can change the voice, but I'll stay with this one. And here is the new stuff, wake word. I can click on this open wake word, and I can select wake word here. I'll choose OK Nabo for start.
Then later I can change it to whatever I wish from this Alexa, hey Mycroft, hey Raspi, and so on and so forth. I'll choose OK Nabu, and I'll click on Create. The final touch is to make this preferred. I just have to click on this star and that's all. Now this pipeline is my default one. Time to give some love to our hardware of choice. In my case, it is M5 Atom Echo. Remember, this is simply an ESP32 board with embedded microphone. If you have something similar like the bigger and louder ESP Muse Lux, you can use the next steps the same way. If you don't have such devices yet, you can buy them from the affiliate links in the video description. That way, this channel will receive a small commission from your purchases with no additional cost for you. Anyways, here is what I did to install ESP Home on the Atom Echo. After that, I'll start the Chrome browser because this is one of the supported browsers, the other one is Edge. And I'll open the following URL. You can get this URL from the video description. And I'll click on this connect button. Then I'll connect my Atom Echo to my computer. I'll click on try again, and here it is, M5 stack is listed in this dialog. I'll select it and I'll click connect. Then I'll select install voice assistant, install. Keep this page visible to prevent slowdowns. Installation is complete. I now have to configure my Wi-Fi. I just realized that I typed wrong password. Let's see what will happen. Okay, unable to connect. I'll type the correct password now. I hope this time it will be fine. Now I can add everything to Home Assistant by clicking on this label. I'll edit my URL because this is another instance. I'll click on update. In your case, you just have to type your URL of Home Assistant, including the port, and then I have to click open link. I have to log in. We want to set up ESP Home, okay. M5 stack Atom Echo, submit, finish. And everything should be fine now. Now here comes the fun part, testing the waking word and issuing voice commands that will control Home Assistant and my smart home. If I scroll down to the ESP Home devices, I can click on them. And here I can find M5 Atom Echo. I need to press the M5 Atom Echo button to wake the things up. Then I have to click on this use wake word. And now if I say the waking word. Okay, Nabu. Turn on kitchen lights.
Turn on light.
Yes, it is working. The lights are turned on. It takes too much time, but it doesn't matter. The slow response time is because everything is local and I'm running this on a Raspberry Pi 4. If I had a more powerful computer, this will take much less time. I'm pretty sure with that. At this point, your M5 Atom Echo is all set up for seamless voice controlling Home Assistant using only your voice and awakening words. If you found this guide helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more easy tech tutorials. I'm Kirill, happy automating, and until next time, bye!